Today I'm right now I'm showing you the this box, the box with the drawer. Sorry, actually I made the video earlier, but the recording stopped suddenly in the middle, and I finished the box and the video just got stopped. So right now, just bear with me. This box we would be doing. I'm showing you this box with the drawer. Yeah. For that you require, as we did for the earlier thing, the kappa board, scale, pencil, cutter, scissors, glue, the cloth binding tape, and of course the black and white cardstock. Now just take down the measurements. For the book drawer, for the drawer, you need 5 by 6.5 one piece, 7 by 2.5 one piece, 6 1/4 by 2 1/4 one piece, 5 by 2.5 two pieces. And for the book, the measurements that you need, 15 by 7.5 one piece, and 6.5 by 2.5 two pieces. Now rather I had made the box and I just the video didn't get recorded, so there was a problem. So I'll just show you, I'll explain to you rather. Now for the drawer, 5 by 6.5 is the base. Now 7 by 2.5, you're going to stick from the outer edge, from the edge aligning the draw base. So it would be, for example, it would be, now if this is the base and this is 7 by 2.5, you would be sticking this way, while the rest pieces, that is 6 1/4 2 1/4 and 6 1/4 by 2 1/4 and 5 by 2 1/4, they come from top. They are, you are going to stick them from above. Once you stick them with the glue and the tape, binding tape, cover it with the cardstock from all the sides except the front. For the front, you take the white cardstock of that measurement, just half a 1/4 inch less than the 7, so it would be 6.5 by 2 1/4, and then score it on the scoring board to get the book line effect. Now for the box, here I'll show you that 15 by 7.5 piece. For that, in that you leave 5.5 from both the sides, and then so it would be like you'll have just 5 inches in the middle left, 4 inches in the middle left. 5.5 you leave from both the sides, and the rest 4 inches you at every 1 inch interval. 1 inch interval you just draw lines and then deep cut them, as we did for the treasure box. Same we are doing for here also. Deep cut them with the cutter and the scale so that you can give a shape to it. This round shape. Once that is done, the other two pieces, 6.5 by 2.5 piece, you're going to give a curve and cut it off. So those curves are, you're going to attach it over here. The way we did for this treasure box, same way we attach them over here, stick them with the glue and then the binding tape. First with the glue and of course then with the binding tape. Once this is done, for the back side you stick the plain black cardstock. For the front side you take the plain black cardstock, and either you can, if you have a background stamp, you can stamp it with Versamark and then heat emboss it. Versamark and then the embossing powder and heat emboss it. Or you can also have, if you have a stencil, you can use the stencil. Whatever you have, accordingly you can work out. if once this is done, once you stick this paper also over it, just take the embossed black cardstock, which you can just cover the spine. For here, like I have taken 2.5 by 6.5 same size, and I have just cut the white cardstock also in that shape, and then scored it on the scoring board. This is done, and then you put the black cardstock even inside. You stick the black cardstock to cover up all the, so that the kappa board is not seen, and the finishing, we get a good finishing over there. For the drawer, you can put the drawer hook over here, either put a hole and do it, or you can stick it with the glue gun also. After that, it's time for the embellishments. You attach the embellishments with the glue gun. For the wooden, this thing, golden ears, I had just applied black gesso over it, and then you can either use gold, Inca gold, or the golden powder which we regularly get in our market, the golden for the paint in the powder form, and apply it over it, and or even on the spine. And then the rest you can put on the embellishments the way you want it. And the box is done. Thank you.